Hello everyone. In the previous classes, we discussed trigonometric basics as well as trigonometric ratios. Okay. Now, in today's class, we are going to learn about trigonometric identities. In trigonometry, there are three important identities which are very important, and based on these three trigonometric identities, in exam, we will get long answer questions. Okay. Now, just look at these three identities. First identity is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. This is one of the identities in trigonometry. So, from this identity, two more formulas can be derived. See, sin square theta, sin square theta is equals to 1. Here it is plus cos square theta. If it goes this side, it becomes minus cos square theta. So sin square theta is equals to 1 minus cos square theta. In the same way, cos square theta is equals to 1 minus sin square theta. So cos square theta equals to 1 minus sin square theta. So from the first identity, we are getting two more formulas. Okay? These three means along with this identity, and these two formulas can be used in the problems. Next. Second identity, second square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. In the same way, here also we can get two more formulas. Here, first of all, second square theta is equals to 1 plus tan square theta. Here it is minus tan square theta. If it goes this side, it becomes plus tan square theta. So, second square theta is equals to 1 plus tan square theta. In the same way, tan square theta is equals to, means just take this tan square theta that side, and plus 1 comes this side, it becomes minus 1. So what is the formula of tan square theta? Second square theta minus 1. Next, third identity and the last one, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1. Okay, here also the same way, we will get two more formulas. Cosecant square theta equals to 1 plus cot square theta, and next, cot square theta equals to cosecant square theta minus 1. Okay, these are very important identities, and from these identities we will get these six formulas. Okay, all these together we can use in problems. Let us see the problems now, and you need to memorize these three formulas. So if you memorize these three formulas, automatically you will get this remaining. Okay, you have to learn these three formulas, and these three identities can be used in problem. Okay, let us discuss the problems now. Look at this problem. For angle theta, express all the trigonometric ratios in terms of secant theta. It means how many trigonometric ratios we have? There are 6 in total. But already secant theta is itself is a trigonometric ratio. So we need to convert remaining 5 trigonometric ratios in terms of secant theta by using the trigonometric identities. Okay, let us take first sin theta. Now, we need to write sin theta in terms of secant theta. So, sin theta is the trigonometric ratio which is in the trigonometric identity, that is the first one. What is the first trigonometric identity? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Yes or no? So, now let us use this identity here. We know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Yes or no? Now we need to write sin theta in terms of secant theta. So sin theta one side, remaining all are other side. Now sin square theta, and if cos square theta goes to right side, it becomes minus cos square theta. So 1 minus cos square theta. Next, here square is there. If you apply root both sides, means apply square root on both sides. Apply square root on both sides. If you apply square root on both sides, nothing will be changed because you are applying square root both sides. If square roots gets cancelled, the value will be same. So write down the next step here. Just wait. write down the next step by applying square root under root sin square theta is equals to under root 1 minus cos square theta. So I have applied square root here, and then now in the next step square root and square gets cancelled. So we will get here sin theta is equals to under root of 1 minus cos square theta. Next, we know very well that cos theta is the reciprocal of 1 upon second theta. Yes sir, why I am writing cos theta in terms of second theta? Because we need to write the sin theta, the trigonometric ratio of sin theta in terms of second theta. So each and every term in the value of sin theta should be in second. So that is why I am writing everything in, means I am converting each and every thing which is in the right side into second theta. Now what is cos theta according to the properties? It is 1 upon second theta, because cos theta is the reciprocal of second theta. So here in place of cos theta we can write 1 upon second theta. So right here 1 upon second theta, and cos square is there. So cos theta is 1 upon second theta whole square. Okay, here LHS sin theta as it is. Next, so apply square to the both the terms, numerator as well as denominator. 1 square means 1. Next, second theta whole square means second square theta. Okay, next, do LCM, otherwise you can keep like this also, because the total term is in second theta and remaining are constants, that doesn't matter. Okay, second square theta if you do LCM, minus 1 as it is, and in denominator again it is second square theta. You can simplify it like this also. At last, sorry, second square theta minus 1, and here root square gets cancelled, you will remain with second theta. So we have converted each and everything in terms of second theta. So what is sin theta value in terms of second theta? It is under root of second square theta minus upon second square theta minus 1 upon second theta. Okay, just don't confuse. If you know all the trigonometric ratios perfectly and all the properties of trigonometry, formulas and everything, these type of problems are very easy. Now let us discuss the second trigonometric ratio, that is cos theta. So now let us convert the second trigonometric ratio, that is cos theta. Now we need to write cos theta in terms of second theta. So here no need to apply any trigonometric identity, because directly we know that cos theta is the reciprocal of second theta. So in one step we will get the answer. This is the answer, because we have converted cos theta in terms of second theta. And the next one, tan theta. Now we need to convert the trigonometric ratio tan theta in terms of second theta. So which trigonometric identity has tan theta in it? Exactly, the second one. I am writing here the second trigonometric identity is second square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. Now we can use this identity to convert tan theta in terms of second theta. So we know that second square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. Yes sir. Next, in the next step, just take this tan square theta this side and 1 to the left side. Now it becomes second square theta. 1 comes this side, here it is plus 1, if it comes this side it becomes minus 1. Is equals to, here it is minus tan square theta, if it goes to right side it becomes plus tan square theta. So what we will get here, second square theta minus 1 is equals to tan square theta. Next, second square theta minus 1 is equals to tan square theta, but we need to convert the trigonometric ratio only tan theta. So in order to get tan theta, we need to apply square on both sides. Sorry, square root on both sides. Okay, now square and square root gets cancelled. So the remaining value is tan theta is equals to under root of second square theta minus 1. Okay, now we have converted sin theta, cos theta as well as tan theta. Now the fourth one, it is cot theta. Okay, cot theta, we need to convert this into secant theta. We know that cot theta is a reciprocal of tan theta. Yes or no? 1 upon tan theta. And already we have converted tan theta in terms of secant theta, in terms of secant theta, yes or no? So we can write in place of tan theta under root of secant square theta minus 1. Because tan theta, what is the value of tan theta? It is under root of secant square theta minus 1. So we can substitute the value of tan theta here. 1 upon under root of secant square theta minus 1. So we have converted cot theta also in terms of secant theta. And what is the value of sin theta that we have converted before? It is under root of secant square theta minus 1 divided by secant theta. Yes or no? So this is the sin theta in terms of secant theta. So what is the remaining one? And the last one, it is cosecant theta in terms of secant theta. So just do one thing. What is the reciprocal of cosecant theta? It is sin theta. So 1 upon sin theta. We know the value of sin theta. What is it? Under root of secant square theta minus 1 divided by secant theta. So just if you exchange the numerator to denominator and denominator to numerator, then it becomes cosecant theta, because sin theta and cosecant theta are the reciprocals to each other. Okay. So in terms of secant theta, the value of cosecant theta is secant theta upon under root of secant square theta minus 1. Okay. Now in the same way, I'll give you one problem. As it is like this, solve it by yourself. Okay. For angle theta, express all the trigonometric ratios in terms of in terms of sine theta. Okay, solve it. This is a very important question for your board exam. Okay, now let us discuss one more problem. See here, prove that cosecant square theta plus secant square theta is equals to cosecant square theta into secant square theta. So now we need to prove LHS equals to RHS, left hand side is equals to right hand side. Okay, by using trigonometric identities. Already I have written three trigonometric identities here. Sin square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1, secant square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1. So just now let us take LHS, that is cosecant square theta plus secant square theta. Okay. Now just do one thing, look at the RHS, it is also in terms of cosecant square theta into secant square theta. Now convert cosecant and secant in terms of sine and cos. What is cosecant theta? It is the reciprocal of sine. Yes or no? So in place of cosecant square theta, I am writing 1 upon sine square theta, because we know that cosecant theta and sine theta are reciprocal to each other. It means cosecant theta equals to 1 upon sin theta. Okay, remember all the formulas, then only you will be able to solve the problems. 1 upon sin square theta is equals to cosecant square theta plus secant square theta is the reciprocal of cos square theta. So in place of secant square theta, I am writing 1 upon cos square theta. Okay, now LCM, sin square theta into cos square theta. Okay, here sin square theta is already there, so 1 into cos square theta numerator, 1 into cos square theta, it is cos square theta. Next, here in the denominator cos square theta is already there, so we need to write the remaining term, that is sin square theta here. 1 into sin square theta. Okay, next, sin square theta plus cos square theta, according to identity number 1, sin square theta plus cos square theta, how much? It is 1. So we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So in place of sin square theta plus cos square theta, we can write 1. Yes sir, according to identity number 1. Next, this is as it is. sin square theta into cos square theta. What is RHS here? 1 upon, sorry, cosecant square theta into secant square theta. Yes, sir. So, here just write separately 1 upon sin square theta into 1 upon cos square theta. If we just mix these two terms, we will get the same term. See, 1 into 1, 1. Sin square theta into cos square theta, sin square theta, cos square theta. So, what is 1 upon sin square theta? It is cosecant square theta. And what is 1 upon cos square theta? It is secant square theta. This is our required RHS. So, LHS equals to RHS. Hence, proved. Okay? So, what do you understand by this problem? If you know formulas and identities clearly, then each and every problem in trigonometry can be solved. Okay? Let us discuss one more problem related to trigonometric identities, which is similar to the same problem. Okay? So, just look at this problem now. Prove that secant theta minus cos theta into cot theta plus tan theta is equal to tan theta into secant theta. So we need to prove LHS equals to RHS. Okay, let us take left hand side terms, that is secant theta minus cos theta into cot theta plus tan theta. Cot theta plus tan theta. Okay, now convert each and every term in terms of sin and cos. What is secant theta in terms of sin and cos, whether it is sin or cos? So if we write a secant theta in terms of cos, then it becomes 1 upon cos theta, because secant theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. Next, minus cos theta, it is already in terms of sin or cos, so no need to convert this. Next, remaining term cot theta. Cot theta, see here, remember, I already told you the previous class that tan theta is sin theta upon cos theta. Yes or no? So, if tan theta is sin upon cos, then what about cot theta? We know that cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta. So, it is the reciprocal of tan theta. So, this also becomes reciprocal, means numerator converts as denominator and denominator as numerator. So what is cos theta in terms of sin and cos? It becomes cos theta upon sin theta, because tan theta is sin upon cos. Okay? Now cos theta is equals to cos theta upon sin theta. You need to remember all these formulas. Next, tan theta is equals to, you know that, sin upon cos. Okay? Now we have converted each and every term in terms of sin and cos. Now do LCM. Here 1 minus cos theta into cos theta, here it becomes cos square theta. Next, in the denominator, cos theta. Okay, next, here also do LCM. Here sin theta is there in the denominator, and here cos theta. So what will be the LCM? Sin theta into cos theta. So in the denominator, sin theta and cos theta will be our, is our LCM. Now in the first term, sin theta is already there, so we need to multiply the remaining term, that is cos theta, to the numerator. Cos theta into cos theta, it becomes cos square theta. And in the second term, in the denominator, cos theta is there, so we need to multiply the remaining term to the numerator. Just cross multiplication. Okay, now it becomes sin square theta. Okay, next, 1 minus cos square theta. Just if you remember the first identity of trigonometry, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So here what is the given term? 1 minus cos square theta. So if cos square theta goes to right side, it becomes 1 minus cos square theta. Yes or no? So what is the value of 1 minus cos square theta? It is sin square theta. So in place of 1 minus cos square theta, we can write sin square theta, since trigonometric identity 1. Okay, 1 minus cos square theta means sin square theta, because from identity 1 we can get this formula. Next, here in the denominator cos theta as it is. Next, again if you look at this term sin square theta plus cos square theta, this is also based on trigonometry 1. We can write here in place of sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Okay, next, sin theta into cos theta as it is. Next, here sin square theta is there, here 1 sin theta is there. So 1 sin theta, there are 2 sin thetas, sin theta, sin theta, it becomes sin square theta. So 1 sin theta gets cancelled. So what is the remaining term in the numerator? It is sin theta. Next, in the denominator, cos theta as it is. And here, what is the remaining term? 1 upon cos theta. Look at the RHS, tan theta into second theta, yes or no? So we got the answer. Just see, sin theta upon cos theta, what is the answer? It is tan theta. And 1 upon cos theta, what is 1 upon cos theta? It is second theta. Okay, this is our RHS, hence proved. Okay, understand? Very good. So let us discuss one more problem. Prove that under root of second theta plus 1 divided by second theta minus 1 is equal to cot theta plus cosecant theta. Okay, we need to prove LHS equals to RHS. Let us consider first LHS. What is that? Under root of second theta plus 1 divided by second theta minus 1. First convert second theta in terms of cos theta. Okay, otherwise we can solve this problem directly by rationalization. I'll explain both the methods. Okay, just first of all convert this second term, second theta term, in terms of cos theta. So it is a reciprocal of second theta. So 1 plus, in place of second theta I have written 1 upon cos theta and plus 1 as it is. Next, divided by, here also in place of second theta I am writing 1 upon cos theta minus 1 as it is. Okay, next, in the next step do LCM. 1 plus cos theta, okay, upon cos theta. So let us apply root here. Just cos theta should be multiplied with 1. So in the numerator you get the term 1 plus cos theta divided by cos theta as it is, because it is a least common method term. It means LCM. Next, in the same way here also, 1 minus cos theta divided by cos theta. So cos theta gets cancelled. Here also in the denominator, here also in the denominator. So this will be gets cancelled. Next, what is the remaining term? 1 plus cos theta divided by 1 minus cos theta. Yes or no? So next, rationalize the given term. Let us solve here. 1 plus cos theta divided by 1 minus cos theta. So what is the rationalized term for this fraction? It is 1 plus cos theta. Whatever the term in the denominator, just reverse the sign, means apply the different sign. See, here it is minus, so here you have to take plus symbol. Okay, and we need to multiply and divide with 1 plus cos theta. We have multiplied and we have divided. Next, under root of 1 plus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta, how much? 1 plus cos theta whole square. Next, 1 minus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta. We know that a plus b into a minus b, how much? We know the formula, a square minus b square, yes or no? So here, if 1 is a and cos theta is b, is b. So a minus b into a plus b, a minus b into a plus b is equals to a square minus b square. So a square minus b square, okay, 1 minus cos square theta. Next, in the next step, 1 plus cos square theta, under root of 1 plus cos square theta, sorry, 1 plus cos theta whole square divided by 1 minus cos square theta. Okay, up to here clear. Next step, in the denominator, look at this term, 1 minus cos square theta. So from the trigonometric identity number 1, we will get 1 minus cos square theta means sin square theta. Yes sir? So write down, sorry, here I am writing the next step, under root of 1 plus cos theta whole square divided by, in place of 1 minus cos square theta, we need to write sin square theta. Next, here square is there, here square root is there, gets cancelled, and here also square there, square root is there, gets cancelled. What is the term we will get here? 1 plus cos theta upon sin theta. Now divide the terms, we will get 1 upon sin theta plus 1 upon sin theta plus cos theta upon sin theta. So what is 1 upon sin theta? What is the formula for 1 upon sin theta? It is cosecant theta plus cos theta upon sin theta. I already told you the formulas. So what is cos theta upon sin theta? It is cot theta. So this is our required RHS. Okay, cot theta plus cosecant theta. So if you know the formulas, then it is not okay. Let us discuss the second method that we can solve this problem. See, what is the resolution term for the fraction second theta plus 1 divided by second theta minus 1? It is second theta plus 1 divided by second theta plus 1. Just we are multiplying second theta plus 1 as well as we are dividing second theta plus 1. So next, second theta plus 1 into second theta plus 1, how much? Second theta plus 1 whole square divided by second theta minus 1, second theta plus 1. Here also this is this we can use one formula, that is a plus b, a minus b. Okay, it is in terms of a plus b and a minus b. So what is the formula of a plus b into a minus b? A square minus b square. Okay, next, see here, second theta plus 1 whole square as it is, second theta plus 1 whole square as it is. Next, second square theta minus 1, second square theta minus 1. Okay, in the next step, just look at the denominator now. The denominator, it is second square theta minus 1, yes or no? So according to second identity, second square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. We can use in the here in place of second square theta minus 1, we can write tan square theta, because in the first, in the at the beginning I have explained why explaining this trigonometric identities. Here we will get two more formulas. So what is second square theta minus 1? Here plus 1 comes this side, it becomes minus 1, and minus tan square theta, if it goes to right side, it becomes tan square theta. So second square theta minus 1 is equals to tan square theta. Okay, next, just write this square as a whole term. Okay, second theta plus 1 divided by tan theta, apply this square to together for numerator as well as denominator. Now square root gets cancelled, what is the remaining term? Sorry, again I am writing square root, yes. Okay, now second theta plus 1 divided by tan theta. Yes sir? Next, what we need here? Cot theta plus cosecant theta. Convert second theta in terms of cos theta, 1 upon cos theta plus 1. Next, tan theta in terms of sin and cos, sin theta upon cos theta. Now do LCM for the numerator term. Just multiply cos theta to the next term, then we will get 1 plus cos theta upon cos theta divided by this is as it is sine theta upon cos theta. So cos theta gets cancelled. We will remain with 1 plus cos theta divided by sine theta. Okay. Now separate the two terms. 1 upon sine theta plus 1 upon sine theta plus cos upon sine theta. So what is 1 upon sine theta? It is cosecant theta. Plus what is cos upon sine theta? It is cot theta. So this is our required RHS. You can solve this problem by either of the methods, but you need to know where to apply the particular formula. Okay, let us discuss the last problem in this trigonometric identity. Okay, look at this problem now. If secant theta plus tan theta is equals to P, means he has given in the problem one condition. If secant theta plus tan theta is equals to P, then prove that P square minus 1 upon P square plus 1 is equals to sin theta. Okay, now let us consider LHS now. What is LHS? P square minus 1, P square plus 1. Yes or no? So what is the condition given in the question? Secant theta plus tan theta is equals to P. In place of P, we can write this term. Secant theta plus tan theta. So secant theta plus tan theta, this is P. Square is there, so square and minus 1 as it is. Next, here also P square means secant theta plus tan theta whole square. Okay, and plus 1 as it is. Now we need to convert this term into sin theta. Then our solution is finished. So it is in form of A plus B whole square. Yes sir. What is here? Secant theta. And here tan theta. So what is the formula? A plus B whole square. Everyone knows this. A square plus 2AB plus B square. So apply this formula now. Here A is secant theta, B is tan theta. So A square secant square theta plus 2AB 2 secant theta tan theta plus B square tan square theta and remaining minus 1 as it is. Okay, in the same way apply A plus B whole square in denominator. Secant square theta plus 2 secant theta plus tan square theta and plus 1 as it is. Okay, next look at this problem now. Just write these two terms together. Okay, secant square theta minus 1. Why? Because if we write these two terms together, we will get one formula by using identity. Okay, secant square theta minus 1. Now we have written these two terms. Yes or no? So what is the remaining term here? 2 secant theta tan theta plus tan square theta divided by next secant square theta plus 1. No need to write this together because we will get the formula from here only. So just write these terms as it is. 2 secant theta tan theta plus tan square theta plus 1. Okay, just look at this second identity. Secant square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. Yes or no? Now take this tan square theta the same. Secant square theta is equals to 1 plus tan square theta. Yes or no? So secant square theta is equals to 1 plus tan square theta. Look at this term, 1 plus tan square theta. So in place of 1 plus tan square theta, we can write secant square theta. Yes or no? Now from this formula, just take this one this side. So secant square theta, here it is plus 1. If it comes this side, it becomes minus 1. Is equals to tan square theta as it is. So look at this term now. Secant square theta minus 1. So in place of secant square theta minus 1, we can write tan square theta. So write down in place of secant square theta minus 1, tan square theta plus this term as it is 2 secant theta tan theta, and the remaining term also as it is tan square theta divided by next secant square theta as it is and 2 secant theta tan theta also as it is. Next, in place of 1 plus tan square theta we can write 1 plus tan square theta we can write secant square theta. So write down here secant square theta. Okay, next here tan square theta is there, here also tan square theta is there. So tan square theta plus tan square theta, 2 tan square theta. So 2 tan square theta plus next 2 secant theta tan theta as it is. Next divided by secant square theta plus secant square theta. So these two terms are same, so we can add these two terms, secant square theta plus secant square theta, it is 2 secant square theta plus this term as it is 2 secant theta tan. Next, here if you observe clearly, we will get two terms as common. One is 2. 2 is similar, means 2 is common to common in these two terms. In the same way, tan theta and tan square theta means tan theta into tan theta. Yes or no? So we will get tan theta in both the terms. So we can get common 2 tan theta here. Here 2 came outside and tan theta also came outside. What is the remaining term here? One more tan theta will be there. So one more tan theta. And here 2 came outside, tan theta also came outside. So what is the remaining term? Second theta. So write down the remaining term here. In the same way, in the denominator also you will get 2 common terms. One is 2 and next one second theta. So 2 second theta, if we take common, what will be the remaining term? Here also same, secant theta plus these two terms came outside, so what is the remaining? Tan theta. Now secant theta plus tan theta, here also secant theta plus tan theta, yes or no? So these two gets cancelled. Okay, next 2 2 also gets cancelled, yes or no? So remaining terms are tan theta upon secant theta. Okay, convert tan theta in terms of sin and cos. So sin upon cos, we know this formula. Next secant theta also in terms of cos, 1 upon cos theta, because secant theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. Now cos cos gets cancelled, the remaining one is sin theta. This is the required answer, hence proved. And I think everyone knows this formula, that a upon b divided by c upon d is equals to a into d upon d into c. Okay, already we have read this formula in class 6th. Okay, no problem. Just if the denominator is same in both the terms, you can directly cancel them. Okay, so just to practice more and more to get perfection, and you have to learn the identities as well as all formulas in trigonometry to get perfection, and practice is compulsory to know where to apply the particular formula. Okay, thank you everyone.